purpose this morning to talk about the price is right. Anybody remember who was that?
Bob Barker.
And I wanted to speak from the 11th chapter of St. Matthew. When somebody's talking back there, they are evidently going to be having another service.
Oh, jeez.
I wanted to deal with St. Matthew, and I'm not going to do much with that in this service. St. Matthew chapter 11 and verse 28. They call Jesus to us to come, and he made it so simple that from that thought I will be speaking later on. The price is right. But in this particular phase, especially dealing with communion, Christ made it so simple and so easy. God made it so simple and so easy. Until we find that a lot of folk are missing the thought of Holy Communion. Many like to take it and go on and do the same thing, continue to do what they've done all their life, whatever it was, whatever it is. But that call of Matthew, of Jesus, by Matthew, the gospel as Matthew sees it, and when the past tense, the gospel as Matthew saw it. The words of Jesus. Verse 28, if you have that particular verse before you. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
Take my yoke upon you.
I will give you rest. Just take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For my yoke is easy and my burdens are light. They call a Bob during the time of this television show. He hadn't retired that long. It's been a while. But the call, and everybody and his show went to gain something. And you can be already there, standing, waiting to bid or make an effort on the price. But someone out in the audience, if they like a person, before they go further, they'll call for a person. And they'll be so excited that when their name is called, come down the aisle shouting, rejoicing because their name has been called, and they're going to take a chance on saying or giving the what they call the closest price or the right price, that they may be have a choice to choose the grand price or the grand prize. Christ have called us from nothing to something. All of us were born in
sin.
I don't care how good you look, and you know I talk about myself a lot. Tell you how good I am, how good I know. It makes no difference with Christ. The invitation is open to all of us. Come unto me. All of you that got problems, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, burdened with sin. When you look that up, and the book will tell you, laden with sin. that's called you problem. Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you peace, rest. I will comfort you in whatever the problem is. And oftentimes, we like to fight our own battles. We like to do it ourselves.
Yes.
I've seen time, and I've said this several times in this church, things that bother me or someone else got on my nerve. And I really want the Lord to, you know, Lord, give me a chance. Let me take care of that guy. But we ought to bring our troubles and our burdens to Christ. All of us are going to have some problems. You can be poor, you can be rich, you can be high, you can be low, you can be black, you can be white, any other color you want to be. You're going to have problems. Why, Pastor? Because all of us were born after the Adamic nature. We were born in sin. David said, in sin did my mother conceive me. I was born in sin, shaped in iniquity, but in sin did my mother conceive me. Adam, the first opportunity God has gave us, was through his son, Adam. Adam had the image of God. Never had to worry about death. And all of us was born under that Adamic nature. Isn't that something?
Yes.
I think about that often. Then I'm almost finished. I think about it because when God created Adam, he said, let us, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, let us make man in our image. Listen, this is God speaking. Let us make man in our image. And what else? After our likeness. Can you imagine what man must have been like? Perfect. Made in the image of the Almighty God. After their likeness. So let's not put a color on man at this junction. Let's not say he was white, not black. Let's not give him a shape. But God loved man. He was man. Man was God's masterpiece. But he had one obligation. What was that obligation? Was to obey. How do we get like we are? Man is obeying. All that he had going for himself, didn't have to die. Made in the image of God.
Yes.
Had some authority.
Yes.
Tilled the garden. Named the animals, whatever you will. Had some authority. But he disobeyed. God so loved us. Thank God for loving a person like me. God so loved us that he gave us another Adam. Because sin had to be paid for. And I'll tell you today, you may think you're getting away with a lot of stuff. But sin will have to be paid for. Now you can accept Christ as your personal Savior, as the one who God gave that would die. He is the Lamb that came. John saw him coming. Said, "Behold, the Lamb of God, that you are
take away
the sins of the world." All that man did, yet God yet loved him. Something had to die. When God searched the heaven and earth, there was nothing that would qualify to die for man. That's why God sent his only
begotten.
And the word begotten means the only one born like that. The only one came like that.
The virgin.
His only son that came like that. His only begotten son.
Hallelujah.
Who bore the image of God. He was God's gift to the world.
Amen.
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 That's why we have Holy Communion. If I don't get to that, I'll keep on doing what I'm doing. But that's why we have Holy Communion. Communion is to remind us that Christ gave his life. When sin was committed, blood had to be shed.
Yes.
That's why we have communion. Something had to die. God loved man so well. So there was no lamb that would qualify to give his life for man. God loved us so well that he gave this son who was only born like that, begotten of God, to do away with our sins. Christ went to the cross. Amen.
Amen.
Oh boy, you want me to get happy? Sure enough, do a dance. When I think about Christ died for me. Doesn't matter how I look, what you think about me, but Christ, my God, died for me. And the blood that you need within itself. Oh, I could talk about that too. The uniqueness of God's blood. That's why Mary gave birth to Jesus. Because the man cannot transfer, or the woman cannot transfer her blood to the man. Did I say that before?
Sure.
Yes.
Man has to transfer his blood. I remember down south. Y'all, anybody down south, don't raise your hand. Don't. When the boys used to sneak around and make the girls pregnant. And then they try to get out and go join the army. You don't know nothing about that since you're so young. But what would happen if she put it on John? The only way that they would know that Mary was right, John had to get a blood test. The woman never had to get a blood test to prove her daughter or her son. Because she bore him in the world. But a man has to get a blood test to prove that he is the child's father. Or to prove that he's not the child's father. God gave us his blood through his son, Jesus Christ. That's why Mary came into the world without Joseph. Otherwise, he would have been Joseph Jr. He came as the man, the son of a living God. When it became questionable, God said to Mary, I said to Joseph, Joseph, fail not to take Mary, thy wife. You hadn't married her yet, hadn't come to her. She's going to have a child. Say it like that. That which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank God for Jesus. Amen. When we have Holy Communion, it is a reminder that Christ died, gave his blood, sacrificed his life for us. And in order to complete that, I would have to say the third day.
Mm-hmm.
Thank God he got up. We would have been defeated.
Yes.
If Christ had not risen from the grave, we would have lost the battle. But Christ won the battle, sacrificed his life, and rose again. Your life